Hey you guys, it's Lacey. This is another house building video for you guys. This house is called Peony Place, and you may have noticed recently that I have sort of been naming my houses like after like certain types of flowers, and well, I guess this house is no different because this house is called Peony Place. Peony is a type of flower, so yeah. I really like this house. I think it turned out really good in the end. It's not like huge, although it kind of is at the same time. I mean, it's not huge, it's like, but it's a larger house. The second story is pretty small. Yeah, I take all that off, and that end piece gets brought in, but other than that, it's not a humongous house. But it is, you know, it is 5 bedrooms, so it still remains kind of big, but oh well. I really like it. I think it turns out really cool in the end, and for some reason that door was glitching out. It was kind of making me mad there for a while, so I end up changing it, the door, just for the simple fact that it was glitching out. I'm like, nope. Anyway, so yeah, I do change that door. I believe I put in a 2-tile door, I'm pretty sure. Anyway, so I'm going in and starting on the roofing, which was kind of a pain in this house because there's so many different like pieces on this house that, yeah, it got to be kind of annoying after a while. So yeah, I don't know. So yeah, I think it turns out pretty good in the end, though. I did speed this part up a bit faster, though. I believe I did. I usually speed my videos up, I believe, 8 times. I believe I sped this one up to maybe 12 times because it kind of took a while on the roofing. So I sped it up a bit faster so that the video wasn't like 40 minutes. So yeah. I'm just changing a few little things in it, and you'll see as the video progresses that a lot of this stays and a lot of it changes, and I don't know, but I really like it. I don't know where I got the idea for this house from. I just knew that I wanted to do a sort of like a suburban house. I mean, I don't know if it's like 100% suburban or anything, but I don't know, it's kind of suburban. So there I am just putting the back porch on. I had to use the little triangle pieces there, and then I'm trying to figure out how I want to do the roof in the back, which it stays like that, except I do put another piece just covering up covering up the porch in the back there. I don't know, I couldn't talk there for a minute. So now I'm going in and putting all the white trim around the roofing, and I'm going to start seeing like what type of windows I want to put in. Because I really didn't know. I was like, what kind of windows do I want to put in this house? I knew I wanted to use larger windows, and windows that were like all kind of similar, so yeah. And so I use this like real like deep sort of like bluish purplish color. I'm pretty sure it's like a, I don't know, it's kind of hard to tell with certain colors what they are because it's like different colors and different lighting. So this color from my perspective is sort of like a bluish purplish color. So yeah, I use that color. It's the first time I've ever used that color. I think it turns out really good in the end. I really like it. I really like the color. I think it like, it sort of like pops. So I really like that. So now I'm going in and doing some stuff on the back. I use that white plaster on those two little turret areas. I really like the back of this house, just because like from the inside there's so many windows on the back of the house that you can see like the whole backyard from like pretty much anywhere inside the house, which I really think is pretty, very pretty, and I really love that idea. So So yeah, as I just change a few things here and there, I'm going to put I'm going to change all of that, and then I'm just going to put windows on this middle area right there. I try and keep the brick free from windows as much as I can. This is the master bedroom slash master bathroom area on that whole end of the house. It's a very large master bathroom. I love making humongous master bathrooms. That's just like something I really love to do. So yeah, now I'm going in and figuring out where I want to put the stairs, because really there's only so many, like, the upstairs is really small, actually. There is 3 bedrooms and 1 bathroom upstairs, but they're small rooms. Actually, there's one that's like fairly larger, but the other 2 rooms are pretty small, and the bathroom's not like super tiny, but it's not very big either, so. This is the upstairs right here. You'll see that 2 of the rooms are kind of smaller, and then the one on the end is kind of a little bit larger. That ends up being the teenage girl's room, so I figure that the teenage girl is going to want the bigger room. And then the other room is sort of like for a teenage boy. So, I mean, like I said, I decorated them like that, but you guys, if you guys want to change that, you can. And then the third bedroom upstairs, I decorated like, I didn't really decorate it too much. I just kind of threw a few things in there, like a treadmill to work out on. And what else did I throw in there? I threw in an art easel, which ends up getting deleted because I sized up that cork board or that, yeah, that cork board thing on the wall, and next to it was the art easel, and it got deleted, so that was kind of a pain. So yeah, now I'm going in and I'm going to go ahead and start the gardening here, which I think turns out really cute. I really love the gardening in the end. Yeah, I really love it. I think it turns out really awesome. So there's a good amount of gardening in this video, like, or in this house. I don't know why, it just I wanted to do a lot. I wanted them to be like very proud of their garden and very like, yeah, very into it. So I did quite a bit in this house. Well, I wouldn't say like a ton, but more than I usually do, I guess. I don't know. So yeah, I do pretty much like I cover like almost this entire front right here, leaving like small grassy areas. And trees, of course. So yeah, that's pretty much it for that. And then I move the that, and I put in a couple trees here and there. And then around the side of the house, I put a little bit of gardening just to make it look very manicured. I didn't want to do too much though, because usually on the sides of people's houses, they don't have like a ton of stuff, but they have a decent amount, so. So this is the back of the house, and this is where I change the roof color to more of a slightly lighter color, and this is where I add on the roof on the back over the back porch area. But I do end up keeping that small porch area or that small balcony area on that second floor. I just thought that was a cute idea. So this is a little garden patch area for your Sims to garden in. I thought this was a cute little idea, making it like kind of enclosed and separated from the rest of the yard. And here is the above ground pool. Well, above ground and below ground. It's kind of like on its own little deck area, so. So there is that. So your Sims can have fun in the pool. And I'm going to go ahead and start on a few of the outs or I mean sorry, the backyard gardening, which there is a little bit out here too, not a ton, but a little bit, you know, just to make it look very manicured and very pretty, because I really wanted this house to have like a decent amount of gardening, so. I think it just looks so much better with gardening, like on lots. It looks so much better. I almost sneezed, but I didn't. I held it back. I held back that sneeze for you guys, and it didn't feel very good. Anyway, so now this is where I already changed that door. So yeah, it was a two tile door that I changed it to. So yeah, I'm gonna go in and start putting on some wallpaper and some flooring tiles to figure out basically just what I wanted to do. I did this home, like, as far as the styling goes, as a pretty good mix between modern and classic. There's modern things and there's classic things. So you'll go through and you'll see, like, it looks definitely very classic in certain places, but then in other places it's like modern things sprinkled in here and there. So I figure, like, the people that live here, they like to have a good mix of both. So yeah, this is the front entrance foyer area. I did a nice little table in the middle there with the rug, with a nice little, like, feature flower or whatever there. And these windows, I found out that those particular windows right there are, like, very hard to find curtains for. Like, the curtains do not fit them windows very well. I don't know why. It was, like, really a pain in the butt. So yeah, you know what? That clock that I sized up on that wall, which I really love, I'm pretty sure that disappears, because in the screenshots, I'm pretty sure that's gone. So we'll have to add that back in. That sized up clock. I think that's such a pretty clock, and especially to size it up. So pretty. So here is the kitchen. I'm gonna go ahead and start that. I do a nice little feature island thing, which I really wish we could put columns in the middle of that with, like, the move objects on cheat, but of course we don't have that cheat yet. So I would have loved to put a column right in the middle of there. I don't know why. I just really wanted to, but oh well. So now I'm gonna go in, and I did put some shelving units above them cabinets, as you can see. I just wanted to give them a little bit more storage, I don't know. Because this house does not have, like, a pantry or, like, any sort of separate area for, like, food storage. So I figured I'd give them some more shelving on top of their cabinets. So yeah, there's the kitchen. Just about done with that. Adding in just a few extra lights here and there. This is the living room. Again, couldn't find any curtains that I really liked, so I used these ones. Nothing wrong with them. They're just very kind of, like, country type. I don't know. But yeah, so here's the living room area. There's only one living room in this house. I used the, like, a dark gray colored furniture theme in here. And yeah. So yeah, the living room sort of looks, yeah, but I do use that modern rug, so it's classic yet modern at the same time. So yeah, I like it though. I think it turned out really good. So here is just a little accent table, just a little bit something extra to put in there, plant there. This is the main bathroom for the house. There is another main bathroom upstairs, so there's two bathrooms. And then the master bathroom. So, three bathrooms in total and five bedrooms in total. So, yeah, I mean, it is a decent sized house. There's the master bedroom is downstairs, which you will see very shortly, and then there's a guest bedroom downstairs, and then there's two kids' rooms, and then the, like, extra room that you can either make a bedroom or you can make, like, what I put in there. I just put in, like, sort of like a skill area. I mean, there's not really a lot in there, but maybe I was just getting sick of furnishing, and I was just like, I'm just gonna throw a few things in there, but I don't know. I don't know. I usually don't though. So yeah, this is the master bedroom. It's very pretty, I think. It's very, like, decorated, very pretty. The wife definitely decorated that bedroom. Okay, now we're gonna start on the master bathroom, which I really love. I really love this master bathroom. I think it's so fancy. It's so pretty. I love it. So I'm gonna go in here and I'm gonna make a shower stall area, and then I add that window in there so you can kind of see into the shower from that area. I don't know, I just thought that was a cute idea to add a window right there. And this area right here is the sink area. It's a his and her sink. It's very big, it's very spacious. I add in a few decorations, a few rugs. That's pretty much it for that side. And then on this little area right here, I add the toilet. And over here, I add just a little towel rack, I guess. And a few paintings, I believe I put in. Yeah. So I really love that master bed or bathroom. I think it looks gorgeous. It's awesome. This is the office. I try a few different things with the curtains, but it just ends up staying like that. I do a very red themed office in here. It's not really very anything very special. I just put a few random things here and there and in there. Just a computer, a chair, a couple plants, and a bookshelf, as you can see. This is the guest bedroom. I really like this guest bedroom. I think it looks really cute. So yeah. For some reason on those windows, I had to hold Alt down just to be able to place those curtains where I wanted to for some reason. I don't know. It was stupid. All right, so now we're gonna go in and put in a few lights in there. We're gonna put in a little sitting area over here, like so. And then over here, I end up putting a love seat and a lamp. So just like they've got their own little living room in there. Granted, they don't have a TV or anything in there, but it's just their own little space, I guess. They don't have their own ensuite bathroom, but oh well. All right, now we're gonna start with upstairs. This is the main bathroom upstairs. Very dark, like darker colors, but it's like a decent sized bathroom. It's not huge, but it's a decent sized bathroom. I really like it. All right, and on the other side we have the sinks over here and the toilet. Put in the decorations. And then I believe I put in a plant right there, and that is done. This is the teenage girls' room. I end up putting them large mirrors behind the bed right there, which I think looks so cute. And then I put a couple pretty lamps in there, a nice big rug, and a desk, and then some more decorations and stuff. And I don't. I can't remember if any of that gets deleted. I don't feel like it does, but who knows? Who knows? All right, this is the teenage boys' room right here. Kind of an odd shape, to be honest, but I thought it was a cute idea to put that bed in that little like separate area so they can feel like almost like they have two rooms, you know? I don't know. Anyways, we're getting ready to come up on the screenshots here in just a minute. So, if you guys want to follow me on Twitter, you should definitely do that at LaceyLovesSims. And don't forget to check out my new website, LaceyLovesSims at blogspot.com. I think you guys will really like it. And don't forget to like and comment on this video and subscribe for daily Sims 4 videos. Thank you guys so much for watching. Bye!